People like stories. People read stories, people listen to stories, and people watch stories. And some of the work that I've been doing over the last 25 years has been working with live theater to tell a series of vignettes that deal with many complex situations. Lately, in the last 5 or 6 years, we've moved to video. One that we did with student health services and drinking choices. The scene, part of it is a debate of whether they should call an ambulance about a girl who has passed out in the washroom. Some people are against it because they're afraid they'll get arrested, where others are for it because she might die. We ask the question, what might you do? Nobody wants to be preached at. An audience is very quickly pick that up and turn off. We want to challenge them into looking at situations and then saying, how might I apply this into my own context? One student in a show that we did a number of years ago said, whew, I thought you were going to come and tell us how not to do drugs. Thanks for trusting us to be able to think through the situations on our own. Part of our work is raw. It's improvisational. We don't know how it's going to turn out. Another particular one is hot seating, where we'll take a character and we ask the audience to ask the character questions. And these probing questions help us understand more about the situation because of the character. We also have the audiences create what we call backstories. What do you think happened a week ago, a month ago? What might have brought that person to this particular place? So that's another. We do rewind. Let's try it a different way. We do inner dialogue, and the audiences say, this is what the person said, but I think this is what they were thinking. At the end of the day, we want our audiences to leave haunted, to begin to think about the scenarios that they've seen, and to think of how they might replay them.